down some. Yes, Lord. You can turn this one down some. Thank you, God.
Sun could eat the water up. Then me and my little sister
so we took our Saturday bath first on Saturday afternoon. And then my three brothers, they took a bath in the same water. And then Grandma came in last and she took her bath. My grandchildren just found that incredible that all of us use the same water. I got a 40-gallon hot water tank and I can't get a hot shower in the morning before I go to work. They done ran out all the hot water. Just stand up there looking at the water, one while they in the mirror in the bathroom. I talked to them about how they go in there and they just turn it down on the electric stove we got, but how my brothers had to chop up little kindling wood. And then we had the wood stove in the kitchen. And, but Grandma could bake a cake, she could make a pie, she could fry chicken. She could do anything she wanted to do on that wood stove. I look back in there at my big old range with 8 eyes on it. I said, thank you, God. You're so good. I remember how they worked in the cotton and the tobacco fields. Oh, bless the Lord. They came and got them at 5 o'clock in the morning and didn't bring them back until 6 o'clock in the evening. And for 11 hours of work, the grown-ups got 50 cents a day and the children got 10 cents a day. And at the end of the week, when you didn't have but $2.50, the first thing Grandmama did was take a dollar out for her tithes and her offering. Made sure she gave God some of the little that she had. Oh, I thank God. I thank God. I thank God. We had an outside toilet. That means you had to dig a hole and go back. Child, I work at a bank now. Sometimes I go in the bathroom. We got 16 stalls in there. I just go from stall to stall, flushing the toilet. That's a good thing. Look what God can do. I just go in there and flush the toilet. They say, you all right, brother? I say, yeah, I'm fine. I'm just thinking. Look. I don't have to go to the outhouse no more. Thank you, God. Well, a little chicken on the table for dinner. Well, when we was little kids, we had that little chicken playing in the yard. Called him Peck Peck. Now, we done played with Peck Peck all week long. Come Sunday, Peck Peck done went missing. Grandma, what Peck Peck at? Peck Peck in there on the kitchen table. Something. You ain't there until you had to wring a chicken's neck and pluck the feathers out of it. Mr. Purdue do all of that. I just get a pack of it and throw it in my basket. And I go down, up and down the grocery aisle and say, thank you, Jesus. I told y'all I was 66 years old. And so that means I got a few more years in back of me than I got ahead of me. And I want you to know something. There's gonna come a time when all of us, when the Lord is going to call every last one of us home. He said it in his word. He's coming back together, his children. And I want you to know I have no time. See, I'm just trying to do this today. I have no time for foolishness. I've done this too long. I've gone too far. I cannot go back. Concerned about me. They said, Nita, it's too much for you to take care of mommy by yourself. We need to take mommy to the nursing home so somebody can take care of her all the time. I ain't going to tell y'all what I said because y'all don't think preachers use that kind of language. Home, and mama couldn't find her teeth, or she had bumped into something, had a bruise on her. See, them people was gonna have to deal with me. If anything ever happened to me, because mama didn't like walking with her walker. Mama wanted to walk by herself, and but I ain't want them to have to deal with me walking with my mama. I took my mama home with me. want y'all to know we had church. People say, how can you rejoice? Your mother's gone. Well, when you done what you were supposed to do, well, they're here, then you can song. I sing this little song.